You see these around everywhere, especially during Halloween. So what is a jack-o'-lantern? Simply put, a jack-o'-lantern is a carved pumpkin. Today we're going to talk about how jack-o'-lanterns got started. So jack-o'-lanterns have been carved since over 100 years ago, and legends say the jack-o'-lantern tradition actually began in Ireland, where they were first carved out of turnips or potatoes. So why did the Irish start this tradition, and where did the jack-o'-lantern name come from? There are many stories, but one recurring one is about a man named Stingy Jack who tricked the devil twice. When he died, he could neither go to heaven nor hell. The devil, however, pitied him and gave him a lit coal to light his turnip lantern as he wandered through purgatory, and that inspired the nickname Jack of the Lantern or Jack-o'-lantern. There was the rumor that if you followed his ghastly light at night, you would fall into a sinkhole or bog or drown. Eventually, this tradition of Stingy Jack became part of a night called All Hallows' Eve, later Halloween, when the Europeans would dress up in costumes and light bonfires to scare off wandering ghosts like Stingy Jack. When the Irish, English, and Scottish people immigrated to the US, they brought along this tradition of the jack-o'-lantern. Instead of carving with turnips or potatoes, they found that pumpkins were more befitting as jack-o'-lanterns. As more Americans started to celebrate Halloween, the jack-o'-lantern became a huge symbol of Halloween. Every autumn, people continued to visit pumpkin patches, farms, and vegetable stands to pick out the perfect pumpkin for a jack-o'-lantern. Which, by the way, you want to find one that is perfectly round, that way you can sit a candle in it and that won't make it rot faster, because if the candle tips, you know, it's a problem. The need is so high around autumn for jack-o'-lanterns and for pumpkins in general, that the US alone produces 1.5 billion pounds of pumpkins every year. Every autumn, there are also major pumpkin patches and festivals. The Great Jack-o'-Lantern Blaze is made of more than 7,000 hand-carved pumpkins. In Gretna, Nebraska, Valla's Pumpkin Patch has 55 acres of pumpkins and attractions. The Dallas Arboretum and Botanical Gardens' popular Autumn at the Arboretum event has scenes featuring more than 90,000 pumpkins. In Los Angeles, their Knights of the Jack features large sculptures of dinosaurs and other things made completely of carved jack-o'-lanterns. If you didn't know anything about jack-o'-lanterns, now you do. Thanks for joining today's segment.
Welcome to Cartoon Trivia. In what month does the Nightmare Before Christmas mostly take place? Was it in October, November, or December? Be back with the answer.
Hi, this is Kim, and thanks for joining me for the current news.
Princess Mako of Japan has lost her royal status after marrying a commoner. Princess Mako says, "For me, Kei-san is a priceless person. For us, our marriage was a necessary choice to live while cherishing our hearts." Her husband, Komuro, responded with, "I love Mako. I live only once and I want to spend it with someone I love." On the Alaskan Trail, a man had a near-death experience confronting a brown bear, an over 500-pound brown bear at that. And guess how he survived it? By kicking it. Most likely, he didn't look as friendly as this bear. This is Kim, and thanks for joining me for the current.
Welcome back to Cartoon Trivia. What month does the Nightmare Before Christmas mostly take place in? Was it October, November, or December? The film takes place the day after Halloween. Most of the events occur in the month of November. Christmas took place in the third act of the movie, so maybe it's a Thanksgiving movie. Thanks for playing Cartoon Trivia.
Kim, this is Tracy.
Hi, this is Sally.
And thanks for watching SmartFoxTV. Stay foxy!